Hi, I'm Kaylin Martin, the Curatorial Assistant of Amphibians and Reptiles. I'm here in the Alcohol House, which houses more than 250,000 amphibians and reptiles. We're currently on the turtle range. We have the largest North American freshwater turtle collection in the world. For the last 2 years of my life, I have dedicated to these turtle hatchlings that you see behind me. There ended up being about 11,000 turtles in this collection. So why do we have so many? Well, Dr. Michael Ewert gave us this collection in 2005. It was his life's work. He looked at temperature-dependent sex determination in turtles. Temperature-dependent sex determination is the behavior that turtles have that when they're in the nest, dependent on what temperature the nest is, will yield different sexes. Hotter temperatures will yield females, and lower temperatures will yield males. So how was Dr. Ewert getting all of these turtles? Well, he would go out into the field and find gravid females. Gravid means pregnant. Bring back the females into the lab and incubate her eggs in a controlled setting. There are 351 turtle species in the world. This collection behind me, which is just one of six cabinets, looks at 95 different species of the 351. So that's almost a third. Right now, it is currently known that about 40 species of turtles are affected by temperature-dependent sex determination. So that means that when we're living in the Anthropocene, as we are now, with the rising temperatures, that is yielding more females. It just came out in Australia that 99% of sea turtles are female. You need males to perpetuate and sustain these populations. So why do we have so many? I mentioned earlier that we have about 11,000 turtle hatchlings, and that's so we can inform scientists who are starting conservation head starting programs. When you are doing a conservation head starting program, if you don't have your incubation temperature set at the right temperature that will yield 50% male and 50% female, you could have an influx of female if it's too high, or physical malformations will occur, or the eggs won't even hatch. Through this collection, we hope to unlock more information about temperature-dependent sex determination and help conservation researchers counteract the negative effects that we're having on the climate.